lights, camera, action.
Hello everyone, it's Raven Peel here, and you are watching Pirate Voice series about you and your feedback. Today the episode will focus on PvP mode and basically the Colossus PvP battles. I'll be talking about it more deep than I have done in 4th episode because it's the exact time for that. Why so? Right now we have some delay in game with public test of CQ update that was announced quite long ago. So we are getting now the patches, upgrades and other minor updates that are filling the time of the delay for the biggest change in the clan fights for a few years. Seeing how much posts on DevShack are being posted by players and developers, it occurred to me to deviate a little bit from the subject, same time leaving the connection between it and my question that was about the PvP battles on Colossus, so old Vega 3 planet. Highway asked us to make the separate thread for the feedback connected with Colossus. Then, after my quite huge post about the expected Colossus changes requested by you, so my subscribers, and posting my own idea of Arena of Colossus from the 4th episode of Pirate's Voice series, Highway just said that this delayed feedback is in short that what he expected and that suits with the plan of developers to make for the future updates of the game. One more thing that he added is that developers will apply some additional changes before the CQ update, so it's the time to use as a gap month probably for the Colossus and basically PvP changes in the game. So yes, let's just jump to the topic even more deep for now. But first of all, if you have any feedback about the Colossus or you got some hype to say about the new expected changes of PvP in the game, just put it on forums on specific topic. Link is in the description. Firstly, let's describe what we are seeing lately on Colossus PvP battles. I am contributing quite much into PvP in the game, as I call myself more the PvP player than PvE one. So the Colossus Saturday battles are cherries on top for me, when I can blast someone with technology from other star systems than Sirius or Tau Ceti and have some fun from it. Yes, fun. Joy is the mythical thing on Colossus for much people, unfortunately, and it's connected a little bit to Conquest as well. I'm mentioning the Gravitons issue here. Gravitons are made to be a joker item to change the flow of the battle in an instant. Yes, but where the wind goes, where everyone is changing its path infinite times? Yes, it's put into stagnation, so basically nowhere. Same with Joy, throwing them both out of the game like it was nothing. Getting one-shotted by Orbital Strike boosted by Pyro Graviton isn't funny at all, same like finishing someone that has used Green Graviton on 1% of HP. But it wouldn't be an issue if it was used just once or twice for an hour. But Gravitons are wasted habitually, sometimes even without any thought of circumstances of the action he has done. I mean, here the fact when someone uses a Graviton without any real purpose to do so. He pots anyways, but the duel itself becomes irritating. So you would ask me how to change it. As I have already mentioned in the post on forum, increasing the Graviton cooldown will be enough to solve it, but it has to be put with huge real numbers so that people won't be really able to use that much amounts of Gravitons. As I said before, one Gravis spam per hour is really enough. Secondly, even if the Graviton issue is solved, we have to say how the Colossus battles look like themselves. You have to fight solo with some amount of attempts and suit with the technology requested by the system. But let's go back to the first statement now. Colossus battles are solo. But how can it be solo if people are teaming up with themselves? This way we are approaching the second problem, so the teaming issue. And if you want to leave the deathmatches like that, developers have to do something with that. What is enough? As I have written in the post, I don't have the system solution for that, but I think it will be enough just to bundle people that are teaming on Colossus from participating in the battles. So we can apply the button for GMs to block someone with participating on Colossus battles for several deathmatches. That may be the good solution, but people would need to start reporting these players to support. GM will not be able always to join the Colossus as spectator, even if that, then he is not able to spectate every fight on the planet at the same time. And not every ganks are really a teaming ones. The third thing is the problem with energy, but this problem is quite wide, and I have even said few solutions for that in this series and on forums. First is the solution from the fourth episode of Pirate's Voice series about increase of energy cap and orbs itself. Second is lately posted by Geta Grix and me on forums with the Colossus changes. There is even worse issue than on PvE. Player will not wait for you to get enough energy, and with Mantis you can do whatever you want, so stun it, escape from it, etc. You can escape to energy zones that are mostly safe on story planets, but on Colossus you can get ganked everywhere. So if my solution from 4th episode of Pirate's Voice series isn't good enough to suit with the game, here I request different change, just for Colossus, that is connected with change requested by Geta Grix from Ascon server. 3 options to choose from. Increase energy amount from orbs, nullifying the energy usage completely on Saturday battles, or at least decreasing the energy usage for 50% at least. So if someone has bought the 75% membership, then his energy usage would be just 12.5% of current energy usage in the game. That would fit enough to make a lot of PvPs with the energy we have.
As far as you are watching my series, you already know that I have requested a lot of changes for Colossus and PvP matter before. The idea of mine was the Arena of Colossus, introduced early in episode 4, but some of you may not know what is it about in basics. Let's repeat the episode 4 then.
This one is a very broad subject for me. Every person likes something different in PvP in Pirate Galaxy. Some like PvP but doesn't do at all since it's no use to, because of low profits. And the last group of people, these who just don't like PvP and won't do at any case. As a game it should promote all kinds of enjoyment and PvP is the one, but in this game is a little bit suffering. Riot wants to promote the PvP in game by many tournaments. No one could interfere into PvP because it would be made in blocked area, which looks like ancient rally point or conquest point area. It would be single elimination tournament with no more registrations than 10. Well, idea is quite nice and okay, but I would change some of the mechanics. We have our boring weekly Colossus deathmatches every Saturday that doesn't give anything than 5 days being ladder and few cryonite. It causes many salt and unwritten rules exploit due to the way how it's being made there. Now we have few options to solve it. First one is to leave it like this, if people like the deathmatch, but I don't think so. Second is to make there something like daily arena trainings. It could be open not all day due to possible exploits. You could be able to register during the opening time, but you can't land on the planet by yourself. When you register, you pay some variety of cryonite depending on system ship that is currently in use. Star system tech required would change in sequence, so first is Vega, last is Tau Ceti. It would change every day at 12 AM. When two players are registered and system match them, message would pop up to let them to land. If someone doesn't land, he gets 1 minute ban of registering, and the cryonite is lost. If he repeats it second time, he may register only after 24 hours to avoid exploits of this feature. The second player matched there gains the prize of winning, but doesn't win the point. Every won area PvP would be 1 point, every lost 0 points. The PvP would end at 2 wins, so 2-0 or 2-1. And when the arena ends, the winner is automatically sent back to orbit, and the pot to hangar. The area of PvP would be limited, again to avoid exploits. Each period of time, the arena season would end, the points would be resetted, and top 10 of the ladder would receive prizes such like gold, gravis, cryonite, etc. And the third option for Colossus? Let the arena stay till Saturday, and on Saturday the arena closes till the Colossus deathmatch ends. That's best option for Colossus for me. But back to the Raja idea. I wouldn't limit tech there, so all people even full ancient would be able to apply the tournament event. Every spot would be granted with reward, so even the worst would get cryonite. I would abandon the school things. It would be replaced by connecting these tournaments to arena ladder. For first place giving 20 or 30 points would be awesome, and applying these two options I would add the limit to the arena entries to 5, so maximum 5 points would be gainable every day. This way, if you win the tournament, it's like you would do 1 week of arenas every day. I would use Raja's school idea in the way that they would be given for top 3 of arena ladder every season. This way we would know
who is the best PvPer on the server. And that's it.
So yes, this is the idea presented right there in the episode. I think that this delayed time is the great gap to think about such changes to our lovely PvP battle planet. And what do you think about these ideas presented right here? Tell me in the comments or different social medias. That's all I have created for you today. See you and keep watching Pirate's Voice series about you and your feedback. And don't forget to subscribe this channel to get announced of new content right here about Pirate Galaxy Game.